But here we go. The Sony event is live. My body is ready. I'll have to ride the faders here to see if I can get the audio right. So let me know how the balance is as we go through. Yes. Chess. Very expensive chess. All stunts by trained professionals do not attempt. Okay. I mean, I can barely get up out of bed in the morning now, so I'm not gonna... Seems a little loud, no? You back that off a bit. Maybe somewhere around there. If this is just the intro to the event, this is a very elaborate chess-themed intro. But they are referencing any number of things here, for sure. Look at that, they even got the checkerboard. Look at that, is that John Wick reference? Excuse me? That looked like the hotel. What? I'm still trying to really... What? I mean, this is all very well shot and everything, I just... Okay, she just went in there and killed- okay, well that's just Aloy now. Alright, sure. Play has no limits. Ah, yes. Well, that was a very expensive film to do something, I don't know what it was, but... Why is everyone dressed like they're going to Burning Man? Oh, wow, that was a good description.
I'm Jim Ryan, president and CEO of Sony Interactive Entertainment.
Hi, Jim Ryan.
Welcome to the PlayStation Showcase.
Nobody likes you as much as your, the guy you replaced, unfortunately.
And setting the benchmark for creativity and excellence in entertainment. We always love the opportunity to speak directly with our community. The new technology in PS5 enables development teams to build more exciting, immersive and compelling worlds, showcasing their creative vision as storytellers.
Do you think people ever get tired of hearing this exact speech every time a new console generation pops up?
Thank you for allowing us time to share some significant updates and brand new content. So without further ado, let's look at some new and amazing games.
This new hardware allows us to do things we've never been able to do before. 7 years later, this new hardware allows us...
This is a lie.
Not actual gameplay on this one. Alright, here we go.
That is what the Sith believe.
Star Wars, though.
They promise power. Now they wield it.
Pog?
We face the greatest Sith in generations.
Revan? Yeah.
They must be stopped.
Everyone's super erect right now. They're remaking Knights of the Old Republic. Alright, I went from fully erect to only half erect, but I'm still erect. Remade for PS5, are they making that exclusive? That would be a fucking wild ride. I'm not seeing any other anything there. That would be a wild deal. Well, we'll be playing that regardless, I'm sure. One of my favorite games of all time. Lots of people. Very excited about that, I'm sure. I was hoping for a new game, but a remaster, okay. If it's a remaster as good as Resident Evil 2, my body is very ready for that. I'll stop with the gratuitous ass shots. Oh my lord, I just saw our grandchildren! There are children watching this! They don't need to see your labia while you're swinging a sword, come on. What is this even? It's a little bit of, yeah, I agree, it's a little bit of Bayonetta feel going on here. Our Mother in Heaven. Our attempt to guard- it also has Nier vibes, honestly. Defeating our enemies and saving humankind. This is- I mean, Yoko Taro likes to, create characters that he can buy body pillows of and sleep with, so it could be Yoko Taro. Also, it's very, like, Christian-themed stuff, which he's got a weird vibe for, like, first-year university, introductory to sociology, and religion courses. It's like Bayonetta and Nier, I can't figure out which yet. Ah, this thing's called Eve. It's parasiting a cor- like Parasite Eve? Sexy Parasite Eve? What is going- what are these references? Alright, so for those in the RSS feeds right now, I don't know what this is yet. All I know is it's basically a skin-tight suit, and I'm pretty sure I don't need to see her naked now, because it's essentially that already. Alright, lots of Eve references, so when does Adam drop, and when do we get other biblical references? Warning. All right, now what? Oh, quick time events. What is... there's a lot visually going on here. Like... somebody really just wanted to... turn up the particle effects. What is this game? It's like Resident Evil enemies... Project Eve. Okay, it's called Project Eve. An alpha native. Alright, what about Omega? Because you know that's gonna be it. Alright, so, all right, Eve, shiftup.co.kr. It's Korean, possibly. That would explain the particle effects. Korean and Chinese developers love to turn up their effects. Alright, now what's this? New game now. Pirate ships. Cell shading. That sounds like Borderlands.
Your party of heroes can't stop me.
That sounds like Tiny Tina.
Spoiler?
Yep.
It's you, baby.
What? This is... wait, that's a song I know. Isn't that Baby Metal? We've gone full Japanese. Tiny Tina with baby metal. Okay.
You know, and now, like, asking, Tina, why are there guns in a fantasy world? And I am just so glad you asked because
big head mode. It's like they discovered Tiny Tina was like a popular character, I guess, and they just decided that, like, if we can't just have Borderlands, maybe if we just distilled everything that we consider humorous from Borderlands and crammed it into Tiny Tina and then just let her do whatever games we want. Like, this is like a RPG, lots of loot. So it's got the same, oh, that's the unicorn. Friggin' what's his face? It's crystal unicorn or diamond unicorn.
Ready, newbie?
Time for character sheets, baby!
Oh, so they're playing Dungeons and Dragons. Tiny Tina's Wonderlands.
All right,
so Tiny Tina is the DM.
I have a credit scene here. This ain't no super duper hero movie.
The Butt Stallion is back. There you go. All right, Tiny Tina. I mean, it looked good. I'm not against it. Luminous Productions. All right, what's next?
You went on a secret, but I'm a pretty big deal. Real big deal. We are getting out of this city, Homer. I promise we'll go somewhere that loves cats. No more fights. Clean air. Bright skies.
What was that?
What the actual fuck?
What the actual F, that's what I'm saying. Why does this look vaguely familiar to me? Why do I feel like I've seen this before? That doesn't make any sense, but like a... I'm almost positive I've seen this before. This looks very familiar.
Where on earth is this?
Asuka.
Who's there?
And technically not Earth. Well, not what you would call Earth, anyway.
I swear to God, asshole, show yourself!
Show myself? I've shown.
Where are you?
Right here.
Tell me it's not a flying robot.
Oh,
don't do it.
Yes.
Oh, it's a wristband.
Okay, so let me get this straight. I'm somewhere that's not what I would call Earth. I'm seeing a freaking dragon. And
okay.
Oh yeah, I'm talking to a cop. Did I just do that?
Wait.
Terrible writing.
Shit with my freaking mind. Yeah. Okay. That is something I do now. I do magic. Kill jacked up beasts. I'll probably fly next.
Just very big open world.
Oh,
huge.
That's too far. Good to know there was a line.
All sorts of different magical abilities, it's looking like. I'm positive I've seen this before, to some degree.
You're the one that's planning on facing off with Syla. Tanta Syla is the strongest and most formidable of all the Tantas. You will be doing our land a great service by killing her.
Again, lots of particle effects. We are just all in on particle effects today. Forspoken! That's right, yes, that now that sounds familiar. I know we've seen at least a chunk of this before.
Frey. No name for a demon. I am the one you seek. The one and only Tanta Syla.
Interesting. Spring 2022. I'm not sure how I feel about that. I mean, it's not that it looks bad, it just, I can't quite...
Team Rainbow has been the shield.
I don't have the vibe of it yet.
Global threats imaginable.
But,
situations.
Certainly something to keep an eye on, I think. It's new, which is rare. Now we're talking about something that's not new or rare.
We face the greatest
first-person shooters.
Our our world has ever known.
Rainbow Six Extraction! Ah, yes, we've seen the little bits of this as well in the last rounds of events. There was a lot of people that were quite excited about this. I'm an asshole because I'm kind of like over the zombie thing. I have been for like ages. I'm sure there will be a game that brings me back to wanting to just shoot zombies, but I don't know if this is it.
We will move as one. We will think as one. We will do whatever it takes. As one. Together, we enter the unknown. Together, we fight for our future. And no one will be left behind.
Yeah, I just don't know how, like, I'm sure that maybe the folks that are big on Rainbow Six Siege, because it's really, they took Siege and then just planted zombies in it and made it PvE. Smart use of their resources. I just don't know if that's... I don't know if it's for me. It's not that it looks terrible or anything. I just don't know if it's for me. You let us know, like, are you over the zombies thing yet? Let us know in the comment section about that.
Whatever you do, don't go out in the dark. Stay in the
light. This is gonna be Alan Wake, yeah. Bright Falls. Alan Wake remake. We were just talking about this. What a coincidence.
Alice? Alice?
My wife Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
Last night I woke up to a nightmare. I was missing a week. What had happened to me? I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it. With it, I could save myself. I could save Alice.
Carl Stuckey.
I thought he was going to say Carl Sagan for a second. I was like, oh, that doesn't make any sense. Looks like a real nice visual bump. It's obviously, you know, a remaster, of course. It's not a full-on remake. But the visuals have gotten a nice bump. Like we said. Got that 4K. I did see a couple of shots of some of the cutscenes. They look like they've been reworked relatively heavily as well. So if you missed out on it, yeah, man, jump in. Grand Theft Auto 5. This is the game that never dies. And the game that never stops making them so much money. Oh, improved graphics. Are they really, like, updating GTA 5 now? Or is this like the next-gen update, maybe? That was showing off, like, what looked to be some sort of first-person move. Oh, wait, didn't they put that in, like, ages ago? I can't remember if they officially support first person now or not. This game's been around so long, I feel like I'm just, like, trapped in a time loop.
I think we're gonna literally make out like bandits on it.
GTA Online. That's where the real money is, right there, baby. That's... man alive. Many dollars being made. March 2022. All right, next up. This Ghostwire Tokyo? We haven't seen this in a while. All I remember of Ghostwire Tokyo is that Spooky happened and then she left the company. All right, we're seeing more now.
There remains work yet undone. Critical work. People always decry the truth when forced to face it. Still your fear. I will be her salvation.
Mari!
All right.
The time is nigh. The world rests on the precipice.
So is this
transformation?
I'm trying to figure out if this is like all something that's in his head or like the actual Tokyo.
Age will dawn.
I don't know. I mean, it's new again, so I'm there for it. But the little bits of gameplay we're getting there aren't showing us a heck of a lot. Just kind of a typical first person kind of an action experience there. And again, lots of particles, man. They crank those bad boys up.
Guardians of the Galaxy.
Ah, Guardians of the Galaxy. I remember last time we saw this, everyone was very divided on how this game was panning out.
To share it with you. United in the light of belief, all suffering, all grief will end. Oh! Ah! Ah!
What's wrong with you?
Oh, I think... Yeah, I think I'm having a heart attack.
Cease this at once.
Cosmo!
They're doing the writing thing correctly. It's just so hard to see that kind of line being delivered by
like they were drinking funky juice or something.
Those not from the film.
So let us investigate for you.
Always a sketch, Peter Quill. And not fun kind with Bo.
Hey, world mind, long time no see.
The current probability of defeating
the Universal Church of Truth is
0.3%.
Is that bad? It sounds bad.
It is.
I hope you've got one hell of a speech plan, Peter.
That makes two of us.
I'll take you to the stars.
Follow me!
Discount Danger Zone.
By rejecting the promise, you have proven yourselves unworthy.
Better odds than your card drawn magic. Accurate. You know, the trailers look good, but the gameplay didn't do anything for me when we saw it last.
Milano's on her way.
And we didn't see any really now. All right, well, here we are. Maybe it turns out to be good. I think that's one of those games we're going to have to wait for it to come out to really get a good grasp of the gameplay. All right, new game. What are we looking at? Is this Vampires? Is this Bloodlines or whatever? Masquerade. It's vampires with customization options and bad frame rates. Sexy vampires with the ability to deflect bullets with katanas. Wait, is this like a sexy vampire battle royale? What is happening right now? There's like classes? Blood Hunt. Vampire the Masquerade. Yes, okay. Intriguing. 2021. Sign up now, bloodhunt.com. All right, so that drops soon. There you go. Here we go.
Your fashion.
Death loop.
Not just freedom, we offer eternity.
Shut up.
Your esteemed visionaries believe the only thing missing from Black Mirror is you.
The visionaries. Eight geniuses who painted up a prison in name.
So I kind of like the idea of this game. Competing day. I wish they leaned harder into the 60s, 70s, kind of vibe that they're trying to get across. They don't lean in hard enough on it, and so it just kind of feels weird to me. But I like, conceptually, I like the idea.
Brainwashed cultists flinging bombs, whatever these guys are doing, all spewing eons bullshit. So how come I don't remember shit? This Party Island hangover is none my thing. My thing is answers. Who are these people?
It does feel like we've seen this game.
Why is she always one step ahead?
Oh, for a long time. It does feel like it's been a while.
You gotta put this together. Somebody built this place. Somebody's sending me these messages from the future, the past, whenever. And some jackass wrecked every plane out here. Is this a contest for them? Some type of experiment? How does this time loop work? Does anybody remember?
Why is everyone wearing a mask?
What the hell is Ryan's notes anymore?
Who am I?
Like, they're really, they took the Dishonored gameplay thing and they're using that as their core.
Huh. Is that, damn, I look good.
Because it's like, you know, there was a lot of stuff in that series that people never ended up really using because they just didn't, you know, tended to stick to one style. This seems like it's going to end up rewarding making a lot more use of, well, a little bit of everything that they have involved, because it's, you're gonna need to do more in order to get through the game. Unless they're gonna stick to the idea that you can just be stealth, or you can just full-blown, you know, face off against everyone. Either way, you know, those, you know, the Dishonored games were pretty good. So I don't think the game's gonna be particularly terrible, but I do think it needs to come out now. It feels like that game needed to come out last year. But you know, we know why it wouldn't have. All right, next game. What do we got here? Did that just say Kid Amnesia and that was it? That was like the entire teaser? That was... Alright. I don't know what that was. Apparently, Kid Amnesia. Okay, now we're getting something that looks a little indie-like. They're playing, playing that ukulele. Actually playing it, by the way, choosing the chords. Island vibes. Oh, we're turning into seagulls and stuff now. Oh, we're inhabiting animals all over the island. We got a seagull and a dog and a turtle and, oh, it's, oh, wait, now you know what everyone's gonna say. They just jumped off a cliff and had a leaf glider. So, you know, Breath of the Wild comments incoming. I kind of dig the visuals. Oh, is this going to be one of those industry is a game inspired by New Caledonia? This is going to be one of those games where, you know, it's like the industry coming in and it is destroying everything about the island, and now we're going to try and dunk on British Petroleum. I mean, we should.
The biggest pirate treasure of all time is within our grasp.
Oh, Drake is back on my screen, and I'm not talking about his latest terrible rap album. PS5 and PC. We're getting a remaster. Uncharted hitting the PC up.
Everyone obsessed with this treasure gets what they deserve.
Are you ready to seek your fortune?
I mean, they're all good games. So, if you haven't played them, and you have a PC, and you're one of the, I don't know, 90 million people that haven't been able to get their hands on a PS5 yet.
PlayStation Studios.
Herman Holtz
is a diverse and passionate group of storytellers at our collective of AAA studios all across the globe. Everything we do is driven and inspired by storytelling. As creators, PlayStation 5 gives us the opportunity to push the boundaries of storytelling even further.
There it is again.
At PlayStation Studios, have already delivered such incredible gaming experiences for PS5, and we're only just getting started. As you'll see today with the lineup of exclusive games coming for PlayStation Studios, we're going to continue to drive innovation, advance gaming, while always embracing the legacy of PlayStation and creating games that matter, games that you're not going to find anywhere else. Enjoy.
All right, so that does that mean that all the games we're about to see are going to be exclusives? PlayStation Studios logo on there. Insomniac Games. All right, here we go. Marvel. This would be Spider-Man, right? Not actual gameplay. Thank you for the reminder. Unless it would be Wolverine. Yep. Wolverine! It's a teaser. In development for PS5. That's all we're seeing. Which is a Wolverine. Ah, Polyphony Digital. With very fancy music in the background, can only mean one thing. Gran Turismo 7. The driving game for people that like to hold their pinky up when they drink their tea. Or in this case, hold their pinky up while they're drinking their Mountain Dew. Why are they making this sound like a fucking Bloodborne sequel, though? This is why I fell in love with Forza, though, because the Gran Turismo was always a little too hoity-toity for me. It was like, for the love of the vehicle thing, it was like, not quite there. It was like, Gran Turismo has always been very clinical, I guess is the way that I would describe it. Like, super clinical. Oh, wow, car customizations, a livery editor. Alright. Pictures and stuff, yes. Yeah, people like that. Okay. Alright, the usual car upgrades. Oh, we're even getting some racer type stuff. Minor body kit upgrades. Some aero packages. It definitely looks good, as you would expect. I mean, Gran Turismo always very visually impressive. Gran Turismo's like on-track cameras were always really good to me. They went a long way in making the game feel more real. Were the on-track camera stuff that they did. They always did lighting very well, as well. So yeah, looks good. Looks like a good step forward for Gran Turismo. They've been kind of on the back foot for a long while with Forza on the market, and then you know, Forza kind of misstepped in their last mainline game with Horizon now taking over. So there you go. Next game, Spider-Man. This is actually Spider-Man. The Spooter. Two Spodermans! Oh, please do the meme in this video. Literally Spider-Man 2,
will
by the
one
way.
Of you finally give me what I desire. Yes.
Carnage? Venom? Venom! Venom! Fire. As far as I'm concerned, as a complete plebeian when it comes to comic book anything, Spider-Man lives and dies by the Venom and Carnage lines of the story. Everything else has never been really interesting to me. There you go. Shocking development as we've got the Venom movies and stuff as well. So that's gonna be a big hit. Man, that last Spider-Man game they put out for PlayStation was very good. So I'm sure that will also be just as awesome. Next up, God of War. Captured on the PS5 system. I don't know if this is the next God of War or if they're just showing off that they're updating the other one for PS5. Boy,
time is running out. The prophecies say Fimbulwinter leads to Ragnarok. War is coming.
This is two.
My story doesn't end hiding in these woods. I should be out there, finding out who I am, who Loki is.
Uh-oh.
I will not allow you to pick a fight with God.
I don't want to fight anyone. I just want answers.
Uh-oh. If
those answers lead to war with Asgard.
He's becoming.
You do not know what mother wanted.
He's becoming an insufferable teen.
I recognize that dour expression anywhere. Odin's got tricks up his sleeve we haven't dared to consider.
First game was great. Wasn't my cup of tea, but very good game. Unbelievable visuals in the first, and this is also looking incredible.
Well,
dead man, Odin seemed pretty keen on seeing he wasn't found.
If he's out there, we gotta find him.
Come in.
What in all yarns be the hell?
Really good writing in it as well.
Ragnarok to help people. And what if the only way to do that is war?
Oh, we got some trains again.
War is not the only way.
Stop thinking like a father for a moment and start thinking like a general.
No! You seem like a calm and reasonable person.
A calm and reasonable person.
Are you a calm and reasonable person?
Oh, Thor's hammer. Thor is here.
Panic does nothing. Harness it. Let it serve you.
Just unreal visuals and animation come out of the studio. Like, this is by far one of Sony's biggest weapons.
Are you coming with us?
That man was big. What the shit?
Well, some of them.
Oh my lord. That looked absolutely incredible. I got nerd chills and I didn't even really like the first game all that much. 10 out of 10. More updates in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Captured on a PS5 system. Alright, I don't know why that countdown timer was necessary, but here we are. The views and opinions expressed on this program are not those of the person, or those of the person, alright, whatever. Time to reach the youths with some hip hop. Oh! Sizzler! So sizzly. Is this the end? Oh no, there's gonna be one more thing.
And that was the PlayStation Showcase. We've got
no, it wasn't.
More info and updates coming right now. And I'm, in fact, joined by no less than PlayStation Studios head Herman Holst. Herman, really strong showing here from PlayStation Studios tonight, including an awesome new look at GT7.
That's like pat ourselves on the back. Really strong.
GT7 is coming in March, and I don't think fans are going to be disappointed with what Yamauchi-san and Polyphony have been working on. And what we're doing with GT7 is we're pulling from the entire history of the franchise, taking some of the best features into GT7. GT campaign, arcade missions, all that good stuff. And I got a chance to play, and it just looks and plays sensationally. The haptics, the vibrations, you feel the rolls, the pull and the weight of the different cars. I'll tell you, the one thing that I personally really, really liked is the braking variations through the adaptive triggers that really kind of makes you feel like you're an incredible racer. And for me, that's great.
Great to hear that about GT7.
I actually don't know how I feel about the adaptive really triggers. I've had them in games where, when you're shooting guns
on fire
and whatnot, and
year, maybe 18 months with Marvel Spider-Man.
Like, it's a neat idea, but it just feels like it gets in my way.
And now two big reveals tonight.
Maybe with cars it'd be better.
Marvel Spider-Man 2 and Marvel's Wolverine. It's
Wolverine. That's
you work really closely with InSoft.
Gonna be awesome.
What can you tell us about just why Insom gets so fired up about the Marvel Universe.
I mean, Sid, you said it. Insomniac are on fire. They've been just so productive. And I think the team in Insomniac, they're really always challenging themselves to raise the bar with their approach to storytelling and craftsmanship. And it's really evident in the consistently high quality of games that they've been delivering over the years. I think on top of that, they really, really prize collaboration amongst their team. And that collaboration that also extends to the way that they work with other PlayStation teams, but also their work with their great partners at Marvel. And that collaboration resulted in the amazing first two Marvel Spider-Man games. And I know that Insomniac are extremely excited to be further expanding the universe into Marvel Spider-Man.
Insomniac is really...
And they're also going to be raising the bar again, you know, in terms of immersion...
Really became action, visual fidelity. A premier developer
Spider-Man
here now.
Will be a spectacular showpiece for gaming.
They become they're a developer so where to then bring gamers you can just kind of go in assuming it's going to be good.
Journey into Marvel's Wolverine. I think that PlayStation fans are really going to be in for a treat over the next few years.
Very cool, very exciting times, and on multiple fronts. Tonight, we also got our first big look at God of War Ragnarok. Herman, what can you tell us about where Santa Monica Studio is going with this one?
You know, like many of the fans, I'm personally really
his face,
in the relationship
his paused, smiling face. I'm sorry, that was
that
funny.
There's some real tension brewing between him as Ragnarok approaches. So
oh,
you know, I can't wait for players to see how that relationship between him evolves. And you gotta trust me when I say that Santa Monica Studio have prepared quite a few twists and turns for players as they set up the finale of the Norse saga in God of War Ragnarok.
We're gonna get an update on God of War Ragnarok from Santa Monica Studio here in just a moment. But before you go, Herman, I wanted to get your take on Horizon Forbidden West. Now, we've learned that this one is coming out in February. I am sure that by this point you have played it. So what has jumped out to you? What can you tell us about the game?
I've had a chance to play the game on PS4 and PS5, and it looks great on both. For PS5...
Herman really likes looking down his nose, eh? Lighting, like, he's there, he's just...
Even more amazing because the environment
Herman
has
really
so much going on, too.
He wants us to inspect his nostrils at all times. He wants to show the world how clean his nostrils are, how hygienic he is, his nostril care routine.
When you combine these together, that comes in really handy when you're dealing with the new machines. On PS5, the haptic feedback on the controller, I think in my mind...
Look at my nostrils!
...to the experience, you know, when you're firing arrows...
Look at them!
...and the other ammo.
Marvel at them!
I know them so well, I'm super proud of them. They're creating something incredibly special. I just can't wait for gamers to get the next chapter of Aloy's adventure in their hands.
Thanks for the update, Herman. We're joined now by Eric and Corey from Santa Monica Studio. And I wanted to check in with you two on the big announce we saw just a few minutes ago, God of War Ragnarok. We finally got our first big look at it. And actually, Eric, I wanted to start with you. You've been involved with every single God of War, including 2018's God of War. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct, Sid. I've been with the studio since 2004 in many different capacities, working with both Santa Monica and Radio.
This man has been around...
I don't know why.
For a while.
A good idea to say, hey.
Eric Williams.
And so that's what I'm doing. I'm directing God of War Ragnarok, or as Corey likes to call it, never heard of it. So that's the update on that.
Never
so
heard
Eric,
of it.
Why the leadership on God of War Ragnarok?
It's always been a tradition here at Santa Monica to change the directors across the games. You know, we've had really good success with that. Corey's been the only repeat director, and, you know, rightfully so. He's pretty damn good at what he does. So that's kind of what it is.
The important thing for us is to be able to kind of get a fresh perspective each time, but also, you know, a fresh
this man's last name is legitimately
really
Balrog. If that's not
one of these things. So
well, actually, it's Barlog, but I read it as Balrog, and I'm going to canonically call
so
him Balrog now.
Aesthetics or themes sort of resonate with you as a creative. I mean, I guess what I'm getting at is like, how do you see yourself leaving your fingerprints on God of War Ragnarok?
It's kind of the designer in me wants to answer one way, but as a director, you have to answer a different way. I think you have to learn how to jettison your own profession when you switch over to the director's role, which I'm sure Corey can understand. I mean, he kind of animated a little bit on God of War 2, and we kind of had to throw it all out, except for that sneaky backflip that Kratos has never done again that we left in. That's the perk of being the director, I guess. But, you know, from my point of view, like, we want to tell a very heartfelt and epic story as, you know, a father and son. go on a journey, and they kind of struggle with holding on to stuff and letting go of things. You know, it's a very difficult kind of human condition that we all deal with. And we kind of want to arrive at that by taking like slices of life or family, you know, drama, if you will, and kind of juxtapose that against big Norse backdrop. And you know, at the end, we just want to have an ending that feels very
man. It looks so good,
yet inevitable, based on all those things.
Just
it's kind of you know, I'm
what an incredible engine.
Very common, mundane things, and just as interesting as big.
Perhaps even more impressive. Their art direction, and their 3D modeling is just nuts. Look at the fur on the back of that. That's crazy.
It doesn't take a genius to think that perhaps Ragnarok factors into this game in some manner. Can you confirm that, Eric?
Yeah, I mean, you can't call the game God of War Ragnarok and not have Ragnarok happen in the game. So, you know, it's going to happen.
I mean, you could.
Cap off the Norse series with it.
Halo said finish the fight.
The announced trailer last year. Prepare yourself.
But did we?
The last game
did we really?
A teaser of sorts for Thor. And I just got to know, was that Thor's voice we heard in the trailer just a few minutes ago?
That was definitely Thor's voice that we heard in the trailer. Thor is being played by Ryan Hurst, which you might know him from Sons of Anarchy. He played Opie, one of my favorite characters ever. And we're just delighted to have him come play in the God of War sandbox. And his take on Thor and our take visually on Thor is very different than the hunky Australian you might know. You know, he's much closer to the Norse mythology version.
The hunky Australian.
Really almost hedonistic man-child, red hair, you know, left-handed. Just a little off-kilter than the Thor that a lot of people know right now. So I can't wait for people to experience more of that when the game's done.
We also heard the name Odin in tonight's trailer. So I imagine if we're going to experience Ragnarok, Odin's going to have to play a pretty big role here, right?
Definitely.
Smitty, I want Zeus to be played by Mickey Rourke. I want everyone to be played by Mickey Rourke.
Mr. Richard Schiff come on to play Odin for us. You may know him as Toby from The West Wing. This was one that we never thought was going to happen. It was like kind of a shot in the dark, and he got back to us, and we walked him around the mocap volume, and he was just like, I've never done anything like this before. Let's do it. And so the kind of rest is history. So I can't wait for people to experience that and see how he factors in. And it's a very different take, again, much like Thor. You know, he's like a old man who's just kind of busy with his own things and doing whatever he wants. And he doesn't live in a castle or anything like that. So it's a different take, kind of what we do. We just take what's known and curveball it a little bit and, you know, make it special.
We also saw a couple of new characters tonight. So what can you tell us about them?
This interviewer just kills me.
Tyr, the big guy. Yeah, yeah. He's the Norse God of War. And Kratos and Atreus have finally found him. We talked a lot about him in 2018. So we might as well show him to the people. And then the last character we saw at the trailer, you know, like with the little wink and smile from Angerboda. She's one of the last remaining giants. And her story is pretty amazing and how it fits into the world of God of War. Tyr is being played by Ben Prendergast, who's been completely absorbed in the role, even though he is not a giant as Tyr is. And then Angerboda is being played by Leia De Leon Hayes, who's a complete treasure on set. She's been amazing. Watching her chemistry with the other characters has been amazing. And she's one of the last giants that's living. So we have those characters and a few more. And, you know, there's a lot of different monsters you saw in there. And it's been so many talented people at the studio building this trailer and putting it together. I just want to give a shout out to the team. I love you guys. You know, I wish you could be here doing this interview with me. I wish you were all behind me right now at the studio. That would have been completely amazing. And, you know, lastly, to our fans, we have a saying at the studio that we are fans of our fans. And I cannot wait to watch all the tweets, the messages, the reaction videos that you guys put out, and our team to be able to take that into heart and just get excited and hyped and then use that to push us through to finish the game for you guys. So thank you very much.
Now, Corey, we haven't heard a whole lot out of you here tonight. So now that we know you're not directing God of War Ragnarok, I was hoping maybe you could give us a little clue about what you may or may not be working on next.
Oh, you'd like that, wouldn't you? You'd like me to just spill the beans and tell you everything that's going on right now. We're actually doing a bunch of stuff. It's really exciting, all the things that we're doing, and you're tempted to know what is this, but I don't really have anything I can talk about right now specifically, mostly because we're really focused on God of War Ragnarok, that I am incredibly excited that I finally understand that that's what everyone was saying, God of War Ragnarok. I was way off. I was thinking it was something else that they were talking about. I think we'll wait to get any deeper into anything else until later. We'll talk again, Sid.
All right. Well, thank you, Corey, and thank you, Eric. And next up, we have Ryan Treadwell. He's the lead producer at Aspyr. And wouldn't you know, just a little while ago, we got the announcement of a remake for Star Wars.
Now, here we go.
The Old Republic. So, Ryan, I guess
tell me more about what this is about.
Like a remaster of the
original. I want to know this.
It's so much more, Sid. This is a complete remake of this beloved Star Wars story. For Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic remake, we are rebuilding from the ground up while maintaining that integrity of story and character from the original.
So Ryan, how much of a remake are we talking about here? I mean, is this updating some graphics, adding some higher resolution modes?
You know, the original Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic is a true classic and one of our favorite Star Wars stories ever. We want to honor that original story and make it as impactful for players today. In terms of the visuals, we have an opportunity to present this story with a much higher level of fidelity than was possible in the past, while making sure that we're being authentic to what players loved about that original game.
What does that even mean?
Classic Star Wars games to modern consoles. But this is a much bigger project than anything the studio's tackled before. So what can you tell me about the team behind the game?
You're absolutely right. While Aspyr has enjoyed a great relationship with Lucasfilm Games through our work bringing classic Star Wars games to new audiences on modern platforms, this project is on a completely different level to anything we have done before. That's why we knew we had to assemble the right team to do this project justice. We put together a team full of industry veterans from fan-favorite RPGs, even including the original Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. It has been a really rewarding experience to assemble such a talented team to bring back an epic game. Of course, we're also working closely with the amazing teams at PlayStation and Lucasfilm Games. Together, we couldn't be more excited about what we'll be able to show you in the future. All of us are, of course, huge Star Wars fans too. One of the nice parts about building a team to make a big Star Wars game is the ability to...
Man, you gotta tell me more than just what you just did.
We all have different Star Wars memorabilia behind us in every call.
Don't do me dirty.
A good conversation.
All right, thanks, Ryan. Very exciting stuff, and I'm definitely dying to see more of that one.
Thank you, Sid. It will be some time before we're ready to show more, but we're very excited about being able to reveal more in the future.
All right, and that's it for our show.
That tells me it's ages away.
PlayStation.blog and check out all the trailers from tonight's PlayStation Showcase on YouTube. Thanks for watching.
PlayStation. Oh my goodness gracious. Is that it? We've hit the end? It's properly the end now, is it? No more one more thing? You sure you don't want a one more thing? You're positive you don't want to do a one more thing? Okay. You don't want to do one more thing. Okay. I wanted to give you the opportunity, Sony. But, you know. That's fine. Alright. So there you go! You know what? Considering we haven't seen a heck of a lot out of Sony for a really long, long time. That was still pretty good, but I thought we'd see a couple of other things in there. But still, solid. I think just by virtue of showing off Spider-Man, God of War, and Gran Turismo... That's pretty good. A lot of people are going to be excited about Knights of the Old Republic, of course. I wish there was a little bit more info on it. That tells me it's probably like 3 years away. Maybe two, for lucky. 2 years. I hope they do that game right. There was a fan project that was shut down like a year or two ago that was rebuilding Knights of the Old Republic within the Unreal Engine. And so, you know, and that was looking good, and they were doing their best to stay, like, it was basically just going to be a visual update that, more than anything, was some fixes. So, I hope they do right by it. How would I like to see that, that done? Complete, treat it like Resident Evil 2. A complete visual redo. Keep the original game mechanics, but just brush it up a little bit for quality of life and fix it up bug-wise. Otherwise, don't. Knights of the Old Republic is a game that you do not want to mess around with too much. If you turn Knights of the Old Republic into an action game, well, two things are going to happen. One, you're going to be crucified. Two, the expectations will be even higher. Because if you're going to take it outside of its wheelhouse, and that dramatically change how the game plays, it's going to have to be even better to have the core people that are going to buy this game in the first place want to pick it up and play it. But yeah, we will see how that, you know, we gotta wait, see how it all pans out, I suppose. Other than that, God of War again, look great, look absolutely incredible. I'm gonna move this water bottle, I can hear it ringing with my voice. God of War looked incredible. Polyphony seems to be doing a really good job on Gran Turismo 7, from what we've seen. There was that really neat, kind of indie-ish, island game that looked quite fun. Spider-Man looked good. Wolverine, as a teaser is nice because, you know, if the quality, hangs with the Spider-Man releases, then having a Wolverine game that's that good is also incredible news. Most of what was shown today was very strong. So that was nice. Nice to see something from Sony finally. It's just been forever. Hopefully we get a little bit more before the end of the year, but at least we finally got literally anything to talk about.